Okay, I love the smallmouth, but it's time to look for more of those big, huge French River Delta largemouth. So on a sunny, calm afternoon, we decided to fish some of the weedy back bays with logs, lily pads, and a ton of heavy slop, which big largemouth bass love to reside. Using a combination of plastic frogs, the Azuri prop bait, and soft plastics, I knew it was only a matter of time until I came across some more of those big, huge French River bucket mouth bass. Got a nice kind of stuff in here. I haven't seen any fish really moving on the frog, but I missed two that tried to eat that little split-tail grub, but it's a lighter weight. So this is like a punching. It's not like half ounce or 1 ounce traditional real heavy slop like that. It's grass and pads and stuff. So I'm doing the same kind of method of punching, where I pitch up in the air with a slender beaver bait and go through there. So I just want to get through that mat. The fish do not get scared, but just getting through that mat where they're sitting on that canopy and then shaking it a bit, we'll see what happens. They usually find it pretty good when you put it inside there like that. You make a little bit of noise, punch it through, but when they're there, I mean, boy, do they eat it. Not that time, eh? There we go. I knew I had a bite there a second ago. Look how far back the hook is. Whew. I popped that slop a few times, huh? Popped the slop, put it on the edge, boom, missed it, put it back, and that's what you call luck, where you ate it. That's a pretty good sized largemouth again too. Nice, thick, beautiful pig. I love you girls. We'll let you go take some pictures of you. Bears Den Lodge, you said it. They are here, big and beautiful. Pictures, and we'll show you release them. Oof. Okay, when I see distinct stuff, I'll pick that up. And until I see distinct stuff, let's get them to come up. Ooh, that looks unbelievable in there. Wow. I think that's what the largemouth are. Don't know how deep it is. I need to find out. That's, wow. South River is like that, and that's where they go, largemouth. So the smallmouth, look at that. Oh my God, Dad. Don't move, whatever you do. That was a big largemouth, dude. I seen him, big largemouth. Oh my God, how does he miss it? 7 feet of water. Big largy. Oh my goodness. He even made a V. That was big. That was like the one I caught yesterday. Kid you not. Tell me these fish aren't strong here, dude. Oh, huh? How's that for French River largemouth, huh? I told you I saw a big one chasing it. I need to put those poles down because, I mean, that's what you get on the French River right there, right? Anywhere you fish, that's a big old largemouth boy. Probably 6 pounds. He ain't the magic 7. Look at the mouth on that. That's why I have always other baits, plastics ready. He won't eat that topwater. Woo! I'll put him in there. Little swim, huh? Go Oop, a little swim. Look at you. I'd say you're big. Wow. So I just came along this side here, fishing all different kinds of stuff. Deadly looking stuff. But this here is a point in the French River. Remember, there's always current, always subcurrent, side left. There's always something moving around. There's stump fields over here, like everything you want for fish to hold into. And that fish, I was working this little prop bait. You saw that. And the weight coming out. At first I thought it was a pike, but then I seen how wide the head was. And he missed it. Put it down and being prepared, pick up the soft plastic, in this case, a little split tail grub with a 20 pound test. Worked it, what, 15, 20 seconds, 30 seconds, and then there's no missing those bites. Be prepared. Think about places like right up here in the French River at the Bear's Den Lodge, because boy, oh boy, you could be catching the bass of your life. Gonna take some pictures of that beautiful fish and let her go, let her do a business to make more of those big, beautiful fish. Stick around, we'll be right back after my heart rate goes down a bit. See you on the flip side.